topics on the basis of your feedbacks. We will put it here and we will have a voting. So we will vote to those topics. So they will get prioritized. Then everybody can buy their coffee. So that would be a relaxing time, network with each other. Then we come back and then we will pick up those topics. And I think it will take nearby 1 hour of time box to finish as many topics we can out of the prioritized list. So we would be taking it from pending, in process, still done. And we would be summarizing what we have concluded as a group. Okay, so that's the process. Sure, what do you want to do? So we need a scriber. So who keeps talking and writing things? Scribe? Okay, so what should we talk?
Why agile?
Why agile? So why should we move to agile? Okay, career point of view. Okay.
I think
both the things are related. Because see, if the industry is moving towards it, career will also move.
If it has value, then it's better to have career than that, right? Yeah.
So why agile is a good enough? So we can talk about both the options, career, non-career. Good. Why agile? So this is a first topic. Second, what do you like? Keep talking. Not yet prioritized. Yeah. Yeh idhar hai. Idhar hai. Hum logon ka bhi order hua nahi hai.
I think related to this point, pros and cons of agile versus waterfall.
Okay, so we may add it here only.
Comparison.
So, comparison. Comparison.
Agile
versus
waterfall.
Okay. Next. Okay, how product management happens in Agile? Is that the question?
Yeah, I mean, I'm exploring this option, product management. So, what do you say, introduction?
Okay, so what is this product management is all about?
Yeah.
Okay. Related to Agile or general?
In general also.
In general. Okay.
Agile, that's the level.
What is product management? Okay.
So one question I've had always, had struggled with is people find it difficult to define a story point. So how to define a story point?
Chalo, dekh lete hain, but cloud ke hisab se shayad difficult ho jayega.
Yes.
Let's see. Let the audience will decide how to define story point is an estimation technique. So how to define story point / estimation? Let's put it like this. How to do an estimation? So everybody will come. How to define story point or estimation? And it's a controversial topic, but very favorite for interviewers because they keep struggling it, so they want to know what the other person know about it or want to put about it.
Coming from waterfall is always a challenge defining it. Okay, but how do we estimate unless we know what is story point?
True. Yes, testers view. So there are two strong testers community guys here.
एक तो कैपेसिटी प्लानिंग.
तो हाउ डू यू डू अ कैपेसिटी प्लानिंग इन अजाइल?
मींस हाउ टू डू कैपेसिटी प्लानिंग.
वैसे हर एक की प्रॉब्लम है, खाली अजाइल की नहीं है. गुड. सेकंड,
व्हाट इज इन अजाइल?
ओके, व्हाट इज इन अजाइल फॉर टेस्टर? आप अपना सोच लो.
Can I refine that a little bit more? Like how much testing to do within sprint and how much outside?
Alag point. Okay. How much testing inside
sprint?
Sprint is iteration, time box iteration. हमारा एक बचा हुआ है ना
DOR, DOD और acceptance criteria. DOR, DOD और acceptance criteria.
Adopted when the scope of the project get changed after execution of the project.
तो ये तो हर एक जगह के लिए है ना, PMP only.
हाँ, this is common for everywhere.
Yeah, so it's like change management that you are advanced is like you have implemented something and now you are demoing it and then somebody says change it.
No,
Is it something like
that? Science is that the scope which you have developed, you have executed, is not our requirement. Mm-hmm. Our requirement was something different which got misunderstood during initialization of the project.
So what is your question? How to avoid that? What is your question? How to avoid
how
that?
How to avoid that?
How to avoid a communication gap between end user and the development team?
Right.
Is that the point?
Yeah.
लास्ट एक दो ले सकते हैं
लास्ट लेना हो तो एक मिनट ले लीजिए
हाँ हाँ बोलो
मैनेजमेंट को कैसे रिपोर्ट करेंगे स्प्रिंट के रिगार्डिंग मतलब कौन से मैट्रिक्स से आप यूज करते हैं
दैट्स द ब्यूटी ऑफ
ओके सो हाउ डू वी management what is it
how to report to management regarding this
okay how to report to management sir aisa kaise
how to report to
about the project side
management about
the project status
or project status
ha project status
theek hai done okay so we have collected the topics
right.
So now the next step 1 2 3
4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12
how
would agenda
yes so this is how the
agenda will be carried out yeah so this will be like
what the next is plan wo 30th ko hai sprint planning in a distributed environment वो नेक्स्ट 30 को है जैसे वेब सेशन जैसे डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड सेशन होगी ये एस्पिरेशन है ठीक है बट इफ यू हैव समथिंग यू कैन राइट देयर ओके सो नाउ व्हाट वी डू एवरीबॉडी हैज अ फाइव वोट्स ये सब एक ही जगह में ग्रुप कर रहे हैं एवरीबॉडी हैज अ फाइव वोट्स व्हिच दे कैन गिव ऑन चलो सेवन वोट्स हैं एवरीबॉडी हैज अ सेवन वोट ठीक है व्हिच यू कैन गिव टू एनी टॉपिक So if you want one topic to be discussed more than anything else, you can put more votes to it. For example, you can give all the seven votes to one topic also. So how do you vote? You need to put a like this as an indicator of your vote. So what we will do, we will break for coffee so people can give their order. And during this break, everybody should give their votes to these topics. So you can put your stars as many you want to put. Your preferred topics. Once we are back from the break, we will prioritize it as per the number of stars given to a given topic. Okay? So, abhi maine 7 votes kar diye. So, everybody has a 7 votes. Seven stars. Yeah. But it's not necessary that you need to distribute it to 7. You can put it to 2, 3 to 1 or all 7 to 1 as you wish.
Or you can write a number also.
No. You have to put the star on. स्टार ऑन ठीक है तो एंड एंड दिस इज लाइक आवर दिस आवर प्रोडक्ट बैकलॉग और दिस आवर मीटिंग बैकलॉग एंड देन दिस इज व्हाट वी आर डूइंग प्रायोरिटाइजेशन ऑफ आवर मीटिंग बैकलॉग देन वी विल गो फॉर अ कॉफी वी विल पिक अप द टॉपिक्स एंड द डिस्कशन विल बी मैनेज्ड बाय दिस बॉल हाउ दिस बॉल विल मैनेज द डिस्कशन यू विल पिक अप द टॉपिक हु द पर्सन हैज टू अक्वायर द बॉल बिफोर स्पीकिंग सो द पीपल हु हैज दिस बॉल कैन ओनली स्पीक और इफ यू वांट टू टॉक यू नीड टू अक्वायर द बॉल देन ओनली यू Good. So, okay. So we can break for coffee, and you can put your votes. Using agile philosophy, keeping agile principles, and still working at this size is a scaling is all about. Now, you may like somebody was saying that if you have such a huge environment, then maybe the complete purpose of agile is getting defeated. So, it is something a debatable point because. See, you want to have a scaling at a big scale, but scaling at a bigger scale and smaller scale will not have a same level of agility. So, for example, if you are living in a nuclear family or you are living alone in a hostel, you decide whatever you want to do and you can do it. But if you live in a joint family, you can't make your plan like this. You need to see others, you need to manage their dependencies, and then only you can decide something. So, when you work in a scaling, you are living in a joint family. So, that level of restrictions will come because it's not like you alone, there are other people. But still, you can be at an extent agile, which can help you to do better than other joint families. So even I attended the Jeff Sutherland webinar. He was talking about that when we start scaling, we need some minimum viable bureaucracy. So some level of bureaucracy will be coming in when you have some level of scaling. So, but it should be a minimum, it should be a viable. Okay, so here we are with our backlog. So, incidentally, the definition of DAL, definition of ready acceptance criteria is 11. Why Agile is also 11. So, I think why Agile goes first because it's a bit a simple topic. Then we will have a how to report management about the project status. That is the topic which is coming second. Then we have 2 8-pointers, how to avoid communication gap between business and development team. So that's the another one. And what is product management is again 8th topic. Then we have an estimation topic coming here. How to do an estimation in Agile and what is the story point is all about. Then we have a topic on capacity planning. Then we have a testers topic. So what is in Agile for the tester, and then we have a topic like how much testing inside the sprint and outside the sprint. So these are the backlog items. So we are starting at 10:50, and we want to continue this discussion till 11:50, and 10 minutes of the closer where everybody can share their feelings, what they have learned or what they are getting. We usually video record that tiny part of it where we have a feeling, so you can summarize what you have thought about. Okay, how the process will go? I will put the topic in process, and then whoever wants to talk about it, I will read the topic. Whoever wants to talk about it need to acquire the ball and start talking about it. When we reach some consensus, we will write some summary points attached with this topic and move it to done. Okay, process clear? So now we start with why Agile? And it the subtopic was that we need some level of comparison with Agile and Waterfall as well. So this is the topic in process. Who wants to open it? Who wants to talk about why we should be moving towards Agile?
Sorry. First of all, I'm with Nish, so I want to give my introduction. My name is Bharat Joshi, I belong to CTS. So now coming to question, why Agile? Means while you involve on the project side, the most important challenge you get is the requirements. Means until there is the, you cannot say concrete that this is the last thing which you are going to build. And I have seen the feeling that once the things are going to start, then the people realize, no, we are not looking these things. Means till the time it is not appear in front of you, you are not able to decide what is exactly is going on. So once, if you go with the waterfall model, it says that everything need to be phased on a specific phase, but it is not in the reality. So they move to the Agile, means where they are looking for the iterative process, they are going on every deliverable, something like that.
I did Agile, and before doing Agile, the question I had in my mind and in many people's mind is Agile means faster development, you get things done very fast, which I after doing Agile I realized that's not the reality in most of the cases. It's not about doing things faster, it's doing things in more predictable ways. So the biggest thing that Agile does in my opinion is remove the uncertainty part, right? If you compare it with waterfall, if you have a team of around 20 people and the project is say for 6 months or 9 months, it's like a chain where the weakest link can break the chain, right? If the 2 or 3 developers are not doing the job properly or they are not competent enough, by the time you come to know, it's too late, like 4 months have passed, right? So you can remove those kind of uncertainties because you're working in a very collaborative manner on a weekly basis, on a daily basis. And if somebody is not able to do something, you realize within a few days, and other people can jump in to help that person. Because it's more very tight collaboration, which removes uncertainties. And overall, the entire project efficiency may not be that much, but it will definitely go in a more predictable way, and the uncertainties will be reduced a whole lot.
Good.
If I
want
to counter that, what
you
said,
you acquire the boss. That's it.
Okay. Except that, so I have worked in both Agile environment and non-Agile. So one of the things which I keep on, I know the benefit to me. But I don't want to go by the book, because a lot of you what you have said is just bookish things. But this is what I can see, right? So you said that if you go to non-Agile, let's take it to you. Sorry, I'll lose your name.
Bharat.
Sorry?
Bharat.
Bharat. Okay, I'm ready. So Bharat. So basically you said that something were very later on that things were not done in a proper manner. But I have included projects in waterfall. There were no such things that happened. if you do proper reporting, right, you come to know your project manager is good, and if you do proper reporting, you come to know that how much is the efficiency of the team, right? So you have to do it, you can find it out. I've been hearing these things in the book, but so far I am not very much convinced with that. Can you give me some proper example?
No, so let's take it like this. So rather than saying that alternate methodology also does it, he says that do we have an advantage or disadvantage in it? So Pradeep, let's talk about that. Is there an advantage or disadvantage? So some advantages maybe can be acquired in a different way. So let's not get into that discussion, else it will become too complicated.
Yeah.
So focus on that. Is there something, a problem which you see in an agile-based approach, which you feel that we should not be moving towards agile? Or an advantage you see which is there. It may be that Waterfall also can do with it, you can also do it. It's okay. No problem in that. So let's, because else there will be too much.
Yeah, projects were being done with Waterfall also, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Absolutely.
And let's start with the one assumption that we have been in this industry for I think 15-20 years, average IT professionals, and Agile is a phenomena which we are talking about 5-6 years only. Infosys kind of company, Wipro kind of company, they build fortune without using Agile. So it's not like that they were just spoiling money and they were not making money. But yeah, there are different ways of doing things. Okay, so
just one point I want to
let him add it, then we finish to take that.
I think I agree with the collaborative aspect of it. The two issues I found with Agile in real life, first is the level of involvement from the client side, with the client being the product owner and being involved in all the scrums and meetings every day. I found it very difficult to convince the clients who were not used to that. So that level of daily senior client participation in those meetings was not very forthcoming all the time, and I found that difficult to negotiate. And especially the more senior the client is, having been used to Waterfall for all these years, he or she may not be willing to invest that kind of time. The next is with, I think the USP of Agile is having manageable scrums and sprints, which is why it's so easy to do it at the same time. So with that, slight disadvantage which comes about is that you plan 2-3 sprints at one time for a week or 2 weeks, and you can never really predict the complete end date of the entire project. And our clients who are bound by certain quarterly releases or certain time frames, they are so used to with SDLC having knowing exactly the testing start date and the user acceptance testing dates, they're not very comfortable with us just saying that we're doing sprints and we do not know what the final grand estimate is going to be. I think that makes them very nervous because they have some very strict deadlines. Those are the two cons.
Okay.
Good.
When I am saying Waterfall in the Agile, means it is my personal observation that if you see the strength of any Agile, it is in itself a waterfall. Means it is not like that we are not doing the requirement, we are not doing the analysis. Every phase is there. And if you go inside of a sprint, what you are doing, you are taking an umbrella of the Agile thing and you are placing the waterfall model inside of that particular thing. It is like that. Means what I have observed. Means it is my personal thing.
Okay. That was a contributing moment because I still have to understand what Agile is. Recently done CFP, I'm interested. But I have understood Agile is more of a role of requirement. So it's kind of a developing a working software rather than getting into too much of documentation. And yep. Client involvement. That's my understanding is as because I just started looking into Agile.
You to Pradeep.
And but I was correct, I was watching the webinar in the US. They used to pronounce it Agile.
Okay.
So we are Agile. I should not be pronouncing it incorrectly.
In India, we just use the word Agile.
I don't know how to pronounce it. I'd rather stick to the correct pronunciation. What is it?
Okay. So we will bring it to.
So I also have that concern. Very good point. Regarding client not being available. I am also, I just want to hear a bit regarding how do you see whatever you said, I am agreeing with that. Like each sprint carries all the stages of a waterfall model, that's fine. But what I want to really understand is how do you estimate the complete, I would say, 7 sprint. How do you estimate that after 7 sprints you should be able to deliver this? So that is where I think.
Go, ek alag topic mein ja rahe hain, estimation. So only just why? So you can stick reiterate his point that it's difficult.
It's difficult, that I know, because this is a real challenge that I have also faced in our company when we follow Agile. So most of the time the people who are there are just on-site coordinators and all those are the people whom you are doing demo. And then there is a layer which you are not aware of. Right?
Okay. Sure. Anything?
I'll be asking a question. I don't know. In my industry, I'm in printed publishing. Nobody's practicing Agile.
Okay. So you should get the answer of IHL. You have not got the answer yet.
I have not got
it. Okay, good.
Yes, yeah. I am planning for the PAY. Yes,
either.
Okay. So point is that we had a conversation, but it has not reached to a conclusion.
Consensus.
Yeah, consensus. Mm-hmm. So. So I acquired the ball. Okay. So you can take it from me. We have been having these discussions in many conferences, in many process related discussions, and we should take from a point that every process has a market, has a context. So it's not like that we can put a one process in all the context. So we need to understand from where this agile context is coming from. So the agile is basically focusing on something called empirical process. So what is this empirical process is all about? Where you are very uncertain about your direction. Where you don't know that I have to deliver A, B, C functionality at the end of this project. You don't know that. You just have business need with you. You don't have a solution specification with you. So when, for example, take an example. If I am a CRM system implementer, and I have my own product, and my product get configured on a customer configuration basis. I know this is the product it would be. I just take the configuration requirement and I just implement it as per those configurations. I don't need to think of too much iterative work. The iterative work is a planned rework work. Iterative means you are planning to do rework. Why do you do a planned rework work? Because you are not certain what you want to make it. If you don't do a planned rework work, you may end up making something which was not needed by the market. So, first, the context of agility is it is an uncertain environment. Now, uncertain environment, we can't have a short like that. For example, Aam Aadmi Party, planning a campaign. It's an agile part. You don't know exactly how the market is moving to work. Okay? If you are planning a particular foreign delegate visit, it's not necessary to be agile. Foreign delegate could be landing on a given time, you would be meeting that time, 5 people, then you could be leaving. So it's not until unless he fell sick on the next day, that it is predictable process. But elections are not predictable process. So if you are building a system which will help a political party to do an analysis related to elections, it has to be agile. Because you can't give a requirement on a market. So that is where the context is coming. Now each context has a problem. Okay, any question till here?
So basically, are you trying to say that agile is good for certain types of
projects
and certain types of
projects
are not good for agile?
Yes. So how it is mentioned is, in general, we talk about the dimension. We talk about two dimensions which decide what is agile, where agile should be done. One is how certain your what are, and how certain your how are. If your how and what is very certain, you don't need agile. You need a defined process. You need a Six Sigma. This lady doesn't need a agile. She has a very defined process of taking order of a burger and delivering it. Okay, McDonald's doesn't need a agile. They need a Six Sigma predictable process. They want to focus on control chart. They want to focus on compliances. Because how and what is clear. When the what becomes confusing, if the cafeteria is organizing a birthday party here, which is also they are doing first time, they are just launching this particular product of a birthday party. They will need some level of agility because they are launching it first time. Once they start doing it again and again, they don't need agility.
I think with your definition, the projects which don't need agile would be very minimal, because even the places where we knew what the architecture was and what the screens were, even there among each screen which field should look like that is customizable by the client. So with your definition, those projects would not go very small.
Very small. Until unless they are government projects. So for many times you have...
I can give an example of government budget which should have followed agile, right? We did a project in Keen for some government project. They had a process for years, right? And it was being used, it was using some old version of Visual Basic. And these guys are very certain about this is how we do things and this is what you need to understand and do it in Java. And we started that initially, it was supposed to be a 6-month project. We did the requirements, we started to take requirements, we came to know there was a lot. Now these guys, because we are building a new system, they want a lot more stuff, new stuff. And the project ended, finally we, you know, re-scoped the project to 9-month thing. But still, you know, during those discussions, there were new requirements were still coming. Ultimately, at the end of 9-month project, you're not able to deliver a satisfactory quality of the project. It was done from our side, but they still thought, you know, this was miscommunicated and all those things. Had we used Agile, what would have done was, maybe by the end of 9 months, we wouldn't have been able to deliver the entire project, but maybe would have delivered the 60-80% of the working product, right? And they would have gone to market with that. Not market like within their company.
Yeah. So ideas, you would have retained that client.
The idea is there is more collaboration, that's number one. And then the predictability that I was optimized. As you mentioned, requirements always change. Especially with today's world and the web application world, there's always new requirements. They always keep coming. Because when people see something, so they have some idea in their mind that, okay, I want this. When you give some replica of that thing, okay, this is how it is, then they have new ideas. Oh, maybe we should do this and this, right? So requirements always change.
Good. So, you want to add something?
Before discussing this, all the things, we have to also understand the stakeholder on the project. Right now, we all are the technical people. So we can understand a lot of aspects, a lot of things. But if you think from the client perspective, he is not a technical person. Means a button placing here and button placing here, for him it is a simple task. But maybe for us people, it is a very big challenge for us. That is right.
True. So that's the first part of it. I'll just add a few more details here, and then we close this particular topic. So are we moving towards some consensus on why Agile? At least one consensus is there that there is always a context. So there is a what and how uncertainty, and that is what it decides.
You cannot use Agile for building Burj Khalifa.
Yeah, you can't. See, if you are making a custom, in a PMI language, we use a methodology. We talk about predictable methodology, we talk about adaptive methodology. So predictable methodology is like you are creating a bridge. DLF making another build. They have been making building forever. Like, they can't change the floor plan after selling it to you. They have given you a floor plan. You have made the payment. They can't say, no, we are changing it, you need to pay 50% more. They can't do that. You have so many clauses and compliances attached to it. They need to deliver as per the floor plan which they have sold to you. So they won't be following Agile because it's predictable. If it's an adaptive life cycle, where it's not yet predictable, things are changing, then we come towards Agile. So PMI framework uses this language to talk about predictable and adaptive. The another point is, when it comes to, so there will be challenges. So it's not like that any methodology is perfect. There are challenges, and none of the methodology can give you a perfect project. It's all about how do you implement it. So implementation carries a lot weight, and many times, when we work as a developer, so I'm just putting it on his mind, we only think about solution, page, report. Actually, that was not the business wanted. Business had a need. Business wants to just win the daily election. That's it. No, we keep thinking of yahan pe poster lagana hai, wahan pe poster lagana. It's a solution required. So poster lagana is not the end result. The winning is the end result. So many times as a developer, we don't even know what is this game is all about. We only know about the poster only. We only know that I just have to paint this wall. I just need to put 10 posters. That's it. I don't even know who in this poster is standing. I just don't even know the message. So when you have that kind of division of work, so why that kind of systems? Because we divide the work in a way that there is a contractor, he has nothing to bother about, he just needs to paste the posters. That's it. So usually when we have a predictable life cycle, such kind of division work, because you don't change very frequently. But when we have adaptive life cycle, such kinds of division will create confusions. Poster will get posted, maybe you have changed the candidate website. Because there was some confusion and you changed the candidate and now the other candidate is going to context for his particular assembly. Something like that. Okay? So can we close this particular topic now? Yeah, please.
One last question. So is Agile more of a project management methodology?
Mm-hmm. True. So it's like now in Agile market, the project management word itself is becoming confusing now. Because we in Agile is getting away from project. This is that we are developing products. So, but in general, it's a project management methodology which delivers releases of the projects.
I would like to leave you that. Leaving a project management, now it's project execution, not project execution.
Okay, so we close the first point with some consensus that yes, there is a context to it, and it focuses on many things. And see, what is Agile? Agile is just four statements. The Agile manifesto is the only thing which defines Agile. Now we sometimes take it Agile equivalent to Scrum. Agile is just talking about focusing on working software rather than documentation, focusing on collaboration rather than just processes, focusing on customer collaboration rather than contract, and focusing on changing the plan rather than being following. That's it. If you follow these four values, you are Agile.
The only problem with moving away from this topic is we had a lot of questions about the pros and cons.
Okay, so those things are not discussed. I will just read them and people can decide that if any particular one you want to discuss it. So one point was requirement not clear, it was towards pro. The pro was predictable, transparent collaborator. I think we have to go on. Now you raised the point like difficult to get client collaboration. That was the one point. Manageable scrum and sprints, but that makes difficult to predict the long term forecast.
So these were the
two points which were coming as a problem. And then there was a point.
The question was about long term forecast.
How do you do long term planning?
Quarter ending, year ending.
But if you compare to waterfall,
the discussion is the points are and then there was a frequently made point is that in Agile also we do a waterfall inside the sprint, which is again not the right thing to say. It has a potential. So these are the three open topics. So
first of all,
ये सोच रहा हूँ इनको डिस्कस कब करें, इनको डिस्कस अभी करें?
नहीं, वो एस्टिमेशन का तो सेपरेट है.
एस्टिमेशन का सेपरेट है, सो लेट्स एस्टिमेशन वाला कीप आउट. Can you put a discussion related to difficult to get client collaboration in Agile, which is very much needed?
Yeah.
Okay. So this particular topic we talk about.
Can we add one point?
Waterfall wala.
नहीं waterfall वाला नहीं. Means the lifespan of a agile project. Means whatever we are discussing a lot.
Means. Okay. Back here. Difficult to get client collaboration in agile.
So I think it depends from project to project and from client to client. I've seen examples where clients were really happy. Especially there were some concerns about it's a new process, so they have to do work, things differently. But actually clients were happier because they could see the product much sooner than they would see in the normal scenario. So if you communicate the value of Agile in a proper manner, that okay, they may have to give you someone, some business analyst or somebody who is available for interaction throughout the development phase, but overall they will get to see the product faster than in a waterfall. I think all the clients would love that, in my opinion. I've seen clients loving that.
Before he counted it, anybody wants to add? Because you had to counter. You want to counter only. So anybody wants to add? Add, not counter. First add.
In our cases, client is forcing to go on the agile. He wants to involve what is going to happen if I am spending our money on any work thing. Where is my task? In case if I take my example also, if I am planning for a home, the smallest things. If I am not going to involve on those things and give the particular entity to someone else, he will work according to his own mind. So the output at the end of the time, maybe I am frustrated at the time. So in as my situation, I want to involve on every perspective of that.
Good.
I think getting customer collaboration from my perspective, they love to change the requirement regularly. Mm-hmm. And they don't want a rigid polymer. This is what we have said, this is what we are going to do. So in that case, we did there's something very much. Can we change this thing? Can we change this thing? We just deliver a prototype to use the thing and it's fine and it's more full changes.
The industry specific, type of the customer specific, round of that these three in sequence.
You assume I'm going to counter it.
Okay.
No, I agree that regardless of the consequence, clients always want to be more involved and they're happy with it. So Agile is always better. The reason they're not able to do it is either because of the contract with the vendor or the way their teams are structured. For example, when I work with some big four consulting companies like Deloitte, we did all the business analysis, we had all the business analysts, they didn't have any. they only had people coming in after a few days to review the documents. So in those kind of cases, they don't have people to send to the meetings every day. They don't have the manpower, so that was one of their problems. So in those cases, it's difficult for them to be that. The second problem, which the vendor faces, is if the product owner, which is the client, is in the meetings every day, a lot of our internal squabbles and dirty laundry is shared among them. If you only have developers and testers sitting together, a lot of our internal discussions and all are not openly shared in front of the client. So they get to know a lot more about our internal workings than what we would like to. I think those are the two problems.
I think that's the point. How would they come to know about internal workings?
Because they're sitting there.
Because they're all, everyone is in the room, co-located.
Okay, give it to him. Give it to him.
क्लाइंट को इससे क्या लेना देना डेवलपर्स और टेस्टर्स का इंटरनल जो प्रॉब्लम है उसे एज अ क्लाइंट मुझे क्या लेना देना है इट्स योर डर्टी मेस यूज ऑडिटर एंड एज फॉर थिंग अबाउट द प्रो अजाइल थिंग कि कस्टमर को पहले से पता चल जाता है कि कैसा दिखेगा आई थिंक इट्स अप टू इट्स नॉट अबाउट द प्रोसेस इट्स अबाउट द रिक्वायरमेंट मैनेजर्स द बिजनेस एनालिस्ट एंड द प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजर्स इट्स हाउ दे डील विद द क्लाइंट्स कि उनको पहले से वायरफ्रेम बना के दिखा दो उनको पहले से प्रोटोटाइप बना के दिखा दो एंड हाउ विल यू इंटरेक्ट विद देम हाउ विल यू डॉक्यूमेंट द रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड हाउ विल यू ब्रीफ इट टू द डेवलपमेंट टीम ताकि उनको पता चल देयर इज नो स्कोप ऑफ अजम्पशंस एंड आई थिंक दिस कैन बी डन इन वाटरफॉल मॉडल एज वेल
ओके सो यू आर सेइंग देयर आल्सो इट कैन बी डन बट द प्रॉब्लम इज दैट इट डिपेंड अपॉन द अप्रोच यू टेक फॉर द कम्युनिकेशन
Instead, despite of that coaching, because you cannot as a consultant or other whichever company, you cannot see that my project or plan works. I have to do something. Anything, anywhere, I have to do. I mean, so you should tell me whichever you are following, tell them with this technology, you think you have to you need your cooperation in having those kind of processes being done. ऐसा कुछ आपको करना पड़ेगा. So that is what you need to understand. You need to push plan for that.
Actually, you can also insulate from client, like whatever you're doing inside, it doesn't need to know your
full agile. Actually, there is a concept called product managers, at least in Scrum and lot of things in Agile. So there, who are a banda hota hai jisko batate ho ki yaar, are we doing things correctly or not, and he
is a good purpose actually.
In lot of your discussions, not a daily one, you probably stand up generally or nahi aata, but I would say that you need with this product to be not. So if there is no such people coming from the client side, and that is where I think the problem is in our company. Typical product managers are not there, and we are follow agile.
Peak managers.
So client view आपका होता है ना? I would say yeah.
Again, the
client talk ठीक है भाई. हमारा जो onsite manager वही अब उनके बन जाता है. उसके बाद से वो क्या था? Client ने ये बोल दिया तुम ये कर दो. So that is the kind of challenge that we have.
Good. So okay, yeah. Final है.
नहीं I have a question. Yep. Are we saying we are involving client on daily scrum, daily stand-up meeting or what we are saying? Means it is
see,
very...
It all depends upon the context. Mm-hmm. Usually they don't come, but there could be a scenarios where they do attend.
Because so, there is a time frame, means general time distance also is long.
Yeah. So there are various contexts.
Means in general, do we include? I don't
usually
think,
not. Daily usually. Okay, good. So we had discussion. I think few things remain open. Next topic. Depend upon the context. Okay, let's close this. For else this topic will consume rest of our product backlog. It will become a big epic. Okay, so maybe we can have a separate discussion which is based on Agile. So that could be a possibility that we may have a one meetup which is only focusing on these topics. And we take
it. I have given 6 stars.
Okay, that's why she brought it up. Now, second, we talk about definition of ready, definition of done, and acceptance criteria. So are these terms
is familiar to all of you? Definition of ready, definition of done, and acceptance criteria. So somebody wants to define these terms, please, first.
Yeah, so most important thing in Agile is with each story you need to define acceptance criteria. Acceptance criteria is basically the definition of done, right? I would say if the acceptance... No, acceptance... That's the definition of a story being done. That's the definition of story being done. Once you have defined acceptance criteria, I would say the story, I mean, it's... what is that? Definition of ready. That is ready. Story is ready. A story is ready when the acceptance criteria has been defined, and story is done when the acceptance criteria has been developed and tested.
Okay, no problem. अभी question मत करो. आपको आपको इसमें definition add करनी है. Somebody wants to
ask. One question. This is about the story, right?
Only done and acceptance criteria. So let me explain these three terms where they come. Now, there has been an issue of a failing sprint. People commit to a sprint and they don't deliver. So what is this sprint? Sprint is a time box iteration. Next sprint is a commit. In a recent sprint guide, the definition of ready has been introduced formally. It was there in various permutations, but it has been introduced formally. This talks about, is this a story ready to be picked for the sprint? Is it small enough? Is it detailed enough? Do you know enough about it so that it can be discussed in a sprint plan? So, because there could be a case where you give a vague requirement in a sprint planning meeting, and during the sprint you end up realizing that you can't meet that. So, in order to avoid that, the definition of ready has been introduced. Many times, the size becomes one of the important definitions of ready. That story should not be of more than 5 points if you want to allocate into a sprint, because we won't be able to take a bigger story inside the sprint. Many times, we teams, especially who are working in a distributed environment, ensures that acceptance criteria should be attached to the story before it can be discussed in a sprint. Because you don't want to end up into a situation that during the sprint you came to know a lot of acceptance criteria and you figure out that it is too big. Many organizations may end up imposing wireframes also, some level of UI thing also, some level of architecture tables also, that they should be in place before you can pick it for that. So team has to define their own definition and they need to follow it. Okay, this is definition of ready. Now somebody wants to talk about definition of done. Any question on definition of ready? Okay, definition of done,
I understood the definition of ready, but why did we have to reinvent that definition when it's almost the same in waterfall also? In waterfall, if I look at a set of requirements, I would use the same criteria to define it as ready or not.
Yeah, so it's like, see, it's a checklist. So for example, you want to say that as a user, I want to search a job using keyword. Yeah, that is my requirement. Now, is this requirement is 50 point? Then I will say it is not small enough. Then you may want to talk about that as a user, I want to search the job using two keywords. You say it is small enough, it can be taken into a sprint. Now, do we have acceptance criteria? Can there be AND condition? Can there be OR condition? Should I need to put a predictive text to it? Should I need to sort the output? Now, this all should be known in advance. In some cases, not necessarily in all the things. If you believe for your environment, especially when the business is distributed. So you may think of that I need to have a predictable details of a thing, then only I will pick it.
So if I have learned my definition of ready from waterfall, I don't have to relearn it for this.
No. So you just define a table should be ready, acceptance criteria should be ready, size should be small enough, less than 5, less than 8, so something like that. Okay.
In some examples I've seen waterfall, you start two modules on a parallel track, even though they have interdependence. You assume that one will be done beforehand and there will be some integration for that. Over here, we try to make sure if there's any dependence, that story is done beforehand. That's one difference, I would say. The other thing is the size, as Vasaki talked about. Let's say our experience shows that whenever we pick up stories from more than 5 points, that gives the entire team trouble. And let's say some story was estimated to be 13 points or maybe 8 points. So we'd like to break it into two stories. So that would be one.
Anybody know about definition of done?
One question. During the grooming session, when entire team is working to groom all that PBI items, so at that time it's necessary to attach acceptance criteria with all the DOR?
Yeah. So it's not necessary. It depends upon your environment.
So what follow-up question he has raised is the backlog refinement session. So as the requirements are progressively getting elaborated, you may have 50 requirements in your product backlog. So frequently you would be doing refinement during the sprint for the next sprint. It's not for the current sprint. When you do a refinement, is it necessary to attach acceptance criteria to all the stories? The answer is not necessary. But if your definition of ready talks about it, if you say that these stories cannot be picked in the next sprint till the time you have acceptance criteria, you need to do it. So first you define that what is our definition of ready. And those, the story which is ready can only be picked in the next sprint. That's it. You may have unready stories in your product backlog, but they will not get picked in the upcoming sprint.